Hello everyone, my name is George and this is SaaS Master. Today we're going to check out AdGuard, which is an ads remover. Now the difference of this ad remover is that it actually works on desktop from the outside of the browser, not just inside like a Chrome extension or a Firefox extension. It also includes in the deal that I'm going to talk about the mobile phone app and what else? Yeah, desktop and mobile. But it's not all good, so I'm going to talk about the good part and the bad part about it. And right now, I have open YouTube to show you that it actually works on YouTube. It kind of works on Facebook. I don't really like how it works, removing ads. And in Twitter, I didn't find any ads. So these are like the three major platforms that we're on daily. So I'm going to show you how it works. And speaking about phones, on the iPhone app, it's pretty much useless. I don't recommend it. So don't buy this deal if you want to use it on your phone. And for Android, it kind of works also, but it's kind of, I don't know, I don't like it. I'll give you a screen video right now when I finish, and I'm going to use it here on my phone so I can show you how it actually looks. So if your intention is using it on desktop, great. If it's on phone, think about it, and you're going to check out why in this video. All right, so this is YouTube, right? And there's a whole bunch of ads. You got running ads on the side, you got in the beginning of the video, and sometimes in the middle of the video with some banners. Now, I found out that it does remove it on YouTube. So in your case, let's just say you're a business and you're running like musical videos or something like that, and you don't want to have ads running through them, this will work. But heads up, it might work right now, but obviously YouTube always works around all of this. So they might need to update, then AdGuard needs to update. So it's all of these things that you need to be aware of. Now, right now, AdGuard is in a lifetime deal. You can buy it now for the family plan. It's $29 for a lifetime. That means you only pay once and you use it forever. And you can use it for nine equipments, or like nine desktops, nine laptops, or nine phones, or mix, or however you want to use it. All right, guys. All right, so this is YouTube, right? For example, I know this guy, Tech Lead, has a whole bunch of ads. He always has ads, always. So we're going to run through two of them, and we're going to start it, and I'm going to show you that they don't have ads. So let's click on it, and I'm going to actually mute it. All right, so it's muted, so I don't have to, so it doesn't get mixed up, right? So no ads in the beginning. This thing on the right, it's a plugin I have. It's called TubeBuddy. It's a really awesome ad for plugin for YouTube on Chrome. If you want to use it, I'll give you the link in the description. All right, so no ads at the beginning, no ads here on the side. This is where you would see an ad. But heads up, I will be removing the ad guard right now because I'll show you what it looks like before and after. So right now you can see I have ad guard activated right here. And you can see it started right here, ads blocked, 960, trackers blocked. By trackers, it means it blocks the tracking from your site. So you log into a site and they know where you're coming from. So in this case, it's blocked. Threats blocked, zero, I have no threats. And data saved, 321 megabytes. Why is it saved? Because the ad didn't actually show up. So it didn't even load. So it's data saved, right? Okay, so it's activated. That's an ad that they have in the video. It's not a pop-up ad. So let's go through another video of this guy. I'll click on this one now. Same thing. Video just started right off. No ads in the beginning. No ads and banners. Nothing here on the right. All right. So nothing there. Let's head on over now to Facebook. It's another popular platform that we use that we might want to know if AdGuard works or not. All right. So to start off, I think AdGuard doesn't work well on Facebook. They have probably done a workaround it. I had to create a custom, how would you say, a custom field. I'll show you how right now. So for example, let's find an ad. Okay, this is publicity, right? And the ad is showing. Now what I found out, if I stay a bit right here, it will remove it. But at the end of the day, who takes like a minute here to actually wait for the pop-up ad to remove, right? So I created a deal right here. So if I click right here on the ad guard, there's these little filters right here. So block ads on this website. So what I did is I created a filter where it's going to remove this pop-up. So you can see, apply the rule to the website. So I can select which ones I want to remove. So just let me show you right now. Click away from this. So the one I created is, if I hover over this publicity, it's going to remove. So I'm going to hover over it and boom, it removed. That's the one I created. So you can create that right here in the settings, assistant settings, in the block ad settings, and you select the elements that you want to block. Now, in some cases, it works really well, and some cases it does like this. Like I have to hover over where it says publicity to actually remove it. So like I said, it doesn't work that great on Facebook. Now, what I did notice is that there's no ads here on the right. That's pretty cool. Now, on Twitter, this is another popular platform that people are in. I think I didn't find any ads on this, so all of this is normal. No ads here, so it's working great on Twitter. And to show you now again, what we're going to do is we're actually going to turn off the AdGuard. All right, so let's turn it off. Let's go over here, and it's off. Okay, so now it's off, right? And we're going to go to another video of this same guy, right? So let's click on this video now. And boom, there is the ad. There's the beginning ad right now. Remember this ad? All right, so I can't even skip through it. So there's an ad right there. Let's check out if there's an ad on the right. Okay, no ads right now on the right, but you saw that there. Let's go to another video of this guy. There's another ad. There you see. So AdGuard is working on YouTube as of now, right? So that's pretty cool. Now let's go back to Facebook. Let's refresh Facebook without the AdGuard now. And okay, no ads on the right, but let's go down here. Okay, here's publicity. If I hover over publicity, it's not going to remove. So you can see that the AdGuard was working with the setting I set it last time. And Twitter. Let's go back to Twitter. All right, let's see if we can find an ad around here. All right, just searching around. So probably it looks like Twitter is not using ads. Or they're not targeting me. That could be it. A reason, but no ads there. So this is not a good test for Twitter. All right, so what is the difference about AdGuard desktop, like I have it right here, and AdGuard with, I'm gonna turn it back on, with the Chrome extension? The Chrome extension only works inside the browser and it won't work outside. So this works on other apps also and other browsers. And the other part about this is that, for example, the Chrome extension won't block the ads on YouTube. For example, it won't do that. So having it outside will work. So that's a good part about it. Like I said, AdGuard isn't a lifetime deal. So let's head over to the phone. I have an Android phone, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to record my screen, and I'm going to actually share it here also so we see both screen how they're working. All right, so this is my Android phone, and one of the things I don't like is these notifications. So we have this notification, that's one of them, and this is a second one. So and actually, in order for it to work, these need to be on. If I turn it off, it will actually remove it. So it's giving me information if I click on it, and I can disconnect it. And for example, this one, if I click on this one, this is where I deactivated. Now, it doesn't even work on YouTube. So if I open YouTube, it's still going to show me ads. So I don't really see the benefit of it having in the phone, especially because I don't like having those notifications on the top. But you can see there's an ad right here. It says right there, ad, Zona tickets. So that's right there. So basically, I really don't recommend it on phone. It's not something I would use. It works when you use it. If you open the browser, it will work. For example, it will remove ads. But I mean, I don't know. I don't think that's worth it to have it here just for that. Plus, it's probably consuming a little bit more of my battery. So that is the deal right now. Let me show you that what the deal is exactly. Okay, so this is the deal. That's AdGuard. And like I said, it's a lifetime deal. If you buy it from my link, it won't cost you a single cent more. It's an affiliate link and it helps me out to grab more deals and show you what it's capable of. Now, there's two plans available. There's a personal plan and there's a family. The only difference is that personal plan gives you 3 devices and family plan gives you 9 devices. So for $10 more, you get 9 devices instead of 3. I really think it's worth it. That's what I bought and I think it's worth it. It, like I said, I only buy, you pay once and you have it forever. It's activated and it's actually been using it every single day since I've bought it, and it's going to be working right there. So if it's a one-time payment, I think it's really worth it. So there you go, guys. Those are the benefits and the bad parts about AdGuard. And if you guys want to grab it, the link is in the description. Thank you for watching. My name is George and this is SaaS Master.